Good morning, Associate Prof. Dr. Santi, other colleagues, and other viewers. I am here to present my fourth assignment, research methodology. My proposed title is an appraisal of strategy execution of microfinance banks in Nigeria, bank examiner's perspective. I am Oluwaseola Dada Adewole. This chapter discusses the methodology that will be used for this study. It describes the research framework, design hypothesis, population, sampling unit, sampling frame, sample, sampling techniques, data collection method, reliability and validation of research instruments, instrument scoring, method of data analysis, and benchmark for validation of research findings. The microfinance policy framework was put in place by the federal government of Nigeria, and the aim is to establish microfinance bank so that the economically active poor will have access to finance. The independent variable is the strategy execution. There are five independent variables: corporate governance, risk management, board and management, prudential requirement, and mission focus. There are two intervening variables, which is confidence in the subsector, that is MFB subsector, and government policy. The framework is as shown. The microfinance bank, through the strategy, will achieve its goal and objective. A strategy can be taken to a strategic plan and strategy execution. This study is looking at the impact, that is the corporate governance, risk management, board and management, mission focus, and then prudential requirements, how they impact strategy execution in microfinance bank in Nigeria. The intervening variable has been put in right position as advised by Professor Gasali. Research framework. It is opined that strategy execution is more important than the planning of the strategy itself, as said by Kaplan and Newton. Then many microfinance institutions were found by a number of authors that performed satisfactorily in execution of strategy in the recent times. This was attested to the revocation of 224 microfinance bank licenses in 2010, which also attests to the unsatisfactory performance of microfinance banks in Nigeria. Though out of the 224, 121 were later reconsidered, and provisional approval were granted unto them. Some of the provisional licenses were later revoked in 2013 due to similar reasons. The Deputy Governor, Financial System Stability of Central Bank of Nigeria, and other colleagues posited that the rationale for revocation of licenses included, among others, undercapitalization, high non-performing loans, poor asset liability management, high rate of fraud and labor turnover, insolvency and illiquidity, insider abuses and mismanagement. The perspective of bank examiners is justified based on the mandate of the CBN to promote sound financial system. And then one of the objectives of OFIS and SEED, OFIS is the department that is in charge of microfinance bank in Nigeria. The same thing, SEED is also a department in NDIC. This to ensure safe, sound, and stable other financial institutions in Nigeria. The CBN on annual basis, SEED feed microfinance bank to NDIC for routine examination. These are the research hypotheses put forward, and they will be tested at 5% level of significance to make decision on the problem under investigation. The design can be defined as a blueprint for the collection, measurement, and analysis of data based on the research question of given study. Sekaran and Bogi, 2013. The research design will be quantitative study with descriptive survey design. It will be an ex post facto study since the variable under study could not be manipulated, but taken as given. Descriptive study helps to understand the features of a phenomenon. Think systematically, generate ideas for future study and making decisions. Inc., 2013, asserted in Sekara and Bagu, opened as survey aids in collection of information or data in order to describe, compare, or explain knowledge, attitude, behavior. It can also be used to explain a phenomenon. The descriptive survey is relevant for the study as it will help in appraisal of strategy execution of microfinance bank in Nigeria in line with provisions of relevant documents. In a study carried out by Robert Arasa and Peter on the relationship between strategic planning and firm performance, descriptive survey design was adopted to empirically determine the relationship between variables of interest. Correlation was used for data analysis. There are a number of studies that have been done using quantitative descriptive survey. And then for data analysis, a good number of them have used both parametric and non-parametric techniques for data analysis. For instance, Kanu and Isu adopted the scribble survey design to carry out study on microfinance bank operation in Nigeria, constraint and suggested solution and evaluation. Chi-square and bar chart were used for data analysis. The quantitative descriptive survey will be suitable for the study as it will help in eliciting the required information on the appraisal of strategy execution in line with the existing documentary requirement as observed in the routine examination conducted by the bank examiners on the microfinance banks. Among the variable examined during the routine examination of microfinance banks are corporate governance, risk management, compliance with provision of and compliance with provision of MFB guidelines and the strategic business plan. The views of the bank examiner on independent variable as observed during the post-routine examination of MFB will be elicited in the study. Therefore, this study seeks to appraise the strategy execution of microfinance bank in Nigeria from the bank examiner's perspective. Population. Population has been defined by many authors. The total collection of subjects, entire group of individuals, a collection of elements or study universe. The population of the study includes all the bank examiners, from senior supervisor to assistant director, in other financial institutions, supervision department in CBN, and specially insurance institution department in NDIC. These are the two bodies that supervise banks in Nigeria. There are currently 189 bank examiners in office and 55 in seat, making a total of 234. This number will make the population of the study. The number may however change in near future due to retirement, resignation, transfer, or recruitment, but this factor will be adequately covered when the actual work is carried out. Sampling procedure. Sample is a subset of population, and the sampling unit is the element that are available for selection and the sampling process. The sampling unit is currently 195. The reason is that the researcher wish to use those that have spent more than 3 years in the department, because we hope that with 3 years in the department, you must have gone on a number of examinations and then try to understand, to a certain extent, have proper understanding of the microfinance operation. The figure may change also based on the factor mentioned earlier because of retirement, transfer, recruitment, and then resignation. Stratified simple random sampling technique will be used at all cadre of the banks, examiners in CBN and NDIC. Senior supervisor to assistant director. 50 examiners will be sampled for the study, 10 from the seat, and then 40 from office. The proportion of each cadre in the sampling unit will be reflected in the sample. There will be strata for the sampling. This will include assistant director, then the principal and senior manager will be in another bucket, manager and deputy manager will be in another bucket, while assistant manager and senior supervisor will be in another bucket. Random number will be used for the sampling of the 50 bank examiners, after when all the sampling units must have been assigned a unique number. The structured questionnaire will be used to elicit the required data from the bank examiners. Questionnaire is a written set of questions to which respondents record their answers, usually with rather closely defined alternatives. It is a veritable tool for gathering large data, especially in descriptive study. The main setback in the questionnaire is that response may be low, and this factor will be adequately guided during the study. The questionnaire will be closed-ended and adopt 5-point Likert scale. It will have 5 sections with 10 items each. Each section will represent each of the 5 independent variables which we have mentioned before. The intervening variable will be tested in the independent variable they are influencing. Then validity and reliability. Validity is defined as goodness of how well an instrument meets its purpose. That is, how fit is an instrument in measuring what it is designed to measure. While reliability is how consistent is an instrument in measuring what it is designed to measure. Validity and reliability are vital qualities. To determine the validity of the research instrument, the questionnaire will be presented to three experts, one in the area of test and measurement, another one in the area of strategy management, while the third one will be in the area of microfinance. The expert comment will be included in the fashion that will be used for reliability tests. Reliability tests are going to be done through inter-item consistency of measures. This will be done within each of the five sections of the questionnaire, where Pearson product moment correlation will be computed and global alpha reliability score will be obtained using the result of the correlation. The final version of the study will be developed. The final version of the questionnaire will be developed thereafter. A global alpha score of 0.7 or above that will suffice to establish the reliability of the instruments. My supervisor also, both internal and external, will comment on the questionnaire before and after the establishment of the validity and reliability. Pilot test. There is a pilot test that will be conducted to enhance the reliability of the instrument. When the comment of the three experts must have been incorporated, 10 experienced bank examiners, 2 assistant directors, 4 principal managers, 4 senior managers, and 2 managers will be randomly selected for the pilot test, 8 from office and 2 from NDIC. The 10 examiners must have spent more than 8 years as a bank examiner. The reason is that they have experience, and then they will know the operations of the microfinance bank better than those that have not spent that number of years. The result of the test will be used to compute descriptive and inferential statistics like mean, chi-square, t-test, and f-test. The pilot test will help to resolve possible issues like ambiguity, flaws, oversight, and errors in the questionnaire. Data collection. This is the process of gathering data. The sample example will be informed immediately after the random sample is done. Then, the researcher is currently a bank examiner who has spent about 9 years in the department as an examiner. The researcher will administer the questionnaire personally if the option is approved by my supervisor. If otherwise, SurveyMonkey will be used to gather data. The researcher is of high expectation that administration of the questionnaire will be easier, since the researcher is part of the examiner. The researcher can talk with them online, through phone, or physical access to them. Then data analysis. Coding and data entry. The 50 items in the structured questionnaire will be coded using number 1 to 5 for the items either in positive, that is from strongly, agree to strongly, strongly disagree to strongly agree. Then the reverse will be the case for a negative item. Data entry. The study will use either SAS or SPS using data editor through spreadsheet. Editing of data. The data collected will be edited for illogical responses. The questionnaire contains both negative and positive items. This will be communicated to the respondent at the point of administration. Data analysis. T-test will be used, chi-square, and then F-test. Since the study is going to look at observed and expected, so the chi-square will be very, very relevant, while thereafter, T-test, F-test will be applied, and their process will be tested at 5% level of significance. Validation of research findings. The findings of the study will be compared or benchmarked with the findings of similar studies and the annual report on the microfinance subsector in CBN. Thank you.